from the diseases they prevent to the possible side effects. Stay tuned to number one to find out the pros and cons of vaccines. Number 10. Con. Natural immunity is better. Your body is a wondrous thing, and sometimes, often most times, it can actually heal itself from certain very bad issues. Granted, it doesn't work all the time. However, your body is smart enough to know what is good or bad for it in terms of the basic diseases and things that you're getting vaccinated for. Think about it. Sure, the medicine you take for a common cold can help it go away, but we've all had times where it didn't work like it should. And sometimes, just drinking regular water helped get rid of it faster. By saying no to vaccinations, you're allowing your body to grow its own immunity, which can be a bit more helpful in the long run because it'll not have to depend on medicines and such to fight off certain things. Instead, it'll have an improved immune system and will fight off harmful things on its own. Sure, the body can't fight off things like cancer, in most cases, or certain life-threatening diseases. But most of the things that you're going to have your children vaccinated for, yeah, it can actually fight those things off pretty well. Number 9. Pro. Less stress about potential sickness. Imagine this for me, if you will. You have a young child, and one day they start to cough really hard. The worst thing that is happening right now isn't that your child is sick, but rather, it's the worry that you're going to be dealing with something far more than a simple cough. The fear of the unknown is something that every human feels in one way or another. And for a parent, the fear of your child coming down with something major is something you hope you never have to deal with. Which is why vaccinations are something that many parents do. For while they can't prevent every disease out there, they can help ensure that your child doesn't get many of the major ones. You know, the ones that have taken lives in the past. And while it's true that they can cost quite a bit of money, it's literally a case of spending money now in order to ensure calm minds and hearts when your child does start to cough. Because those vaccinations will start to eliminate things in your mind until all you're left with is, oh, the poor dear just has a cough. Number 8. Con. Vaccines can cost a lot of money. Before we talk about the cost of vaccinations, take a moment to like this video and join the Zero to Hero community by using the buttons below. Now, to be fair, there are catches to this one, because there are certain affordable care policies that are in effect right now that actually allow you to get vaccinations for your child at no cost to you. But as we all know, that option doesn't always apply to everyone. And given the state of the world right now, it's very fair to say that many families may not even have that option, which means that they'll have to pay out of pocket for vaccines, and in recent years, that's proven to be a very costly business. So much so that doctors hire security to ensure that the vaccines don't go bad. The security company can call me at any time of the day or night so I can go save my vaccines, says Dr. Irvin, a pediatrician. Those in the refrigerator recently cost $70,000, she said, more than I paid for 4 years of medical school. Granted, you yourself won't have to pay $70,000 for vaccines, but it can be very costly. It used to cost you dollars and cents to get a vaccine, but now it can range from hundreds of dollars to thousands of dollars to get a full sweep of vaccinations for a child. And let's be honest here, a couple thousand dollars is a lot of money for some families, all of which is spent on basically the hope that these vaccines do what they promise. Number 7. Pro. They're not all shots. Allow me to speak to you on a personal level. Very few things in life suck more than needles. And this is coming from a guy who has had shots in his arm, back, and mouth for various medical reasons, and it sucked every time. And when it comes to taking a child to a doctor or nurse's office for a vaccine, all the child sees is the needle, and then they start losing their minds, because they know what's coming. Pain, and lots of it. Screw the band-aid and the sucker we got afterward, there's something unnatural about seeing a needle go into your arm or other body part. That's the thing, while there used to be a time when all vaccines had to be given out via shots, that's not 100% true anymore. Not by a long shot. There are some vaccines that are able to be taken orally via a variety of means, and that means that your children will be able to go in, get the vaccinations, and then get out without having to whine and complain about the needles. Which is a bonus for the parents because that's less stress on them. Medicine has seen the light and it's about time. Now, if we can just get rid of them permanently. Number 6. Con. Side effects are common and expected. You know when you're watching television and a medicine commercial comes on? You'll hear about how a certain product will cure all that ails you in certain facets and blah blah blah. And then, at the end, you'll hear the narrator or someone else start to talk really fast about all the side effects that said medicine will potentially give you, making you wonder why you would ever take that medicine in the first place, no matter what you have. Yeah, vaccines can be that way too. And that's not to say that all vaccines are bad, but it boils down to the most basic of things. We don't always know how our bodies will react to things. You've sometimes taken medicine and it makes you worse. And this is FDA-approved medicine. Well, sometimes a child can get a vaccine in them and then it reacts badly because of an allergy or another ingredient. It has happened before. And it's one of the many reasons that many people are promoting the non-use of vaccines to help ensure that what's supposed to cure them isn't going to hurt them instead. In case you're curious, yes, there are times when these vaccines have had near life-threatening side effects. Number 5. Pro. Vaccines can protect against secondary illnesses. When it comes to what's best for us, we want to know for a fact that when we do something, we're going to get results. And then, if we're lucky, we'll get more than we bargained for. Vaccines are like that. They can help prevent a disease, and because of the immunity you have given your child, they'll have a secondary defense of sorts against certain other things. The best example here is chickenpox. If you have a natural occurring case of chickenpox, you're possibly more likely to get shingles when you get older, as shingles are caused by the chickenpox virus and only activates into shingles later on. But the vaccine can help minimize your chance of shingles, and there are other things it can help prevent too, via the amounts of vaccines that are out there. So you're potentially not just protecting them from one thing, but from many. Number 4. Con. Certain preventable things aren't. That being said, nothing is ever a sure thing. There have been many cases where someone who has gotten the chickenpox virus has later on gone on to get shingles despite having the vaccine put into them. And while many of the preventable diseases that can be immunized via vaccines can prevent things like seizures, those same vaccines can also cause seizures. In other words, it's a crapshoot at times, whether they'll work or not. You'll just have to have faith in regards to what will work or what doesn't. Number 3. Pro. It's doctor recommended. Now, that being said, if you don't trust your own judgment, that's fine. There's someone else you can trust for theirs. Your doctor. For while many medical treatments have a hit-or-miss quality to them that can divide doctors, a vast majority of doctors out there in the world today will say that you should go and get vaccinations for your children. Heck, even late-night hosts like Jimmy Kimmel have gone to doctors and brought them onto the show to promote the use of vaccines, because he knows that doctors truly know best in most cases. Now, if it was just a small contingency of doctors, yeah, I could understand you being hesitant, but this is a large number of them who preach using vaccines. That says a lot. Number 2. Con. Many diseases are gone for good. It's hard to put a number on this, but there is some truth to the fact that there are a lot of diseases out there that have vaccines that we honestly don't need treatment for anymore. And the rest are either low risk to children or very unlikely to have a breakout within them. Great examples of this are polio and smallpox. Once upon a time, these were two of the deadliest diseases in the United States, even getting President Franklin Delano Roosevelt. But because of the vaccines that were made during the time to combat polio and smallpox, the diseases literally went out of circulation. Fast forward 60 years and no one gets them anymore, with or without vaccinations. Granted, you could go to another country and get them, but that's unlikely for a child, don't you think? And while chickenpox sucks, and trust me, it does, it's hardly the worst thing that can happen to a child, as I've noted earlier. So why waste your time, money, and stress on vaccines when most times what you're curing isn't something that'll happen naturally anymore? Number 1. Pro. Vaccines save lives. All right, look, we've done a good job here showing you both the pros and cons of vaccines. But if we get right down to it, there's one rather undeniable fact about vaccines. They save lives. And there are plenty of numbers to back up this claim. There are thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, very likely millions of kids who are out there right now that have gotten vaccinated and they have had no major issues with those vaccinations. Sure, there will be side effects. and there's no guarantee that it works 100% of the time. But what it really comes down to are the chances that you are taking by not giving them these vaccines. There are a lot of harmful diseases out there in the world right now, and some of them can be prevented from infecting your child right here and right now if you get a vaccine. So the real question is, how far are you willing to go to protect your child? Will you get them the vaccine? Or will you risk them getting something that you could have honestly prevented? The choice is yours. What is your stance on vaccinations? Let us know in the comments below and take care.